Hey, hello students, again here Karate sir, and I welcome all of you to this video lecture. This video lecture is about the great spirit of the Sal tree. Fifth class. And the name of the lesson is lesson number 5, the great spirit, the great spirit of the Sal, the great spirit of the Sal tree is the name of the lesson. And students, page number 46 and page number 56 and 57 I have completed, I have discussed them. But before I am going to continue the lesson, I am going to give you the previous story of this lesson, that there was a king, Indian king, and he wanted to build a palace. What type of palace? Big, richer, stronger, taller, more beautiful. That type of palace that king wanted to build. And also, students, one different also one thing was there, that king wanted to build a palace over or upon the wooden column, and that wooden column should be strong, single wooden column. And that wooden column should be strong. Yes, wooden column should be strong. So that's why that king sent ministers, total 30 foresters to his kingdom, far and near in the forest. And students, that king told the foresters that go to my forest far and near and cut down the strongest and mightiest tree and bring it to me, bring it to the city. What, students? That king told, king ordered. Here is the king. Yes, king ordered to 30 foresters that go to my kingdom far and near and cut down strongest, mightiest tree and bring it to the city without delay. The mightiest tree they can find. Why the king wanted, yes students, why the king wanted mightiest tree? Because he wanted to build the whole palace upon a single wooden column, upon the single wooden column. And the column curved from one of the biggest trees in his kingdom. So he sent 30 foresters. Go. And very important thing, 30 foresters were dispatched, but they soon returned saying that though there were many trees equally strong in the king's forests, They could never carry or drag them over the difficult terrain that lay between the forest and the city. Yes, that we have completed, we have learned, student. That they said that they could never carry such a big tree because the road to the city is not good. Road to the city is not good. Okay? So that is the problem. That is the problem. And now what happened next? We are going to learn, we are going to discuss in this video. Page number 57. Then the king heard this, but later he sent for the foresters again. By means of horses, one of these trees must be brought here, he said. It is not possible, they said. No horse could move such a tree even an inch. By means of bullock, he said. The bullocks could not possibly force their way through miles of such a dense forest. Then by means of elephants then? It is hardly possible, for the ground is so marshy that the elephants would sink to their knees in it. Very well, said the king angrily. If you cannot bring me such a tree from the forest, then you must find it within one of my village parks. Bring it here within a week. Because the 30 foresters were not able to drag that trees from the forest, to carry that trees from the forest to the city. So that's why they could never drag or carry such a big tree, they told. But kings told them first, by means of horses, first one is the horse. By means of horses, means take horses, and by using horses, you have to bring that such a big tree. One of these trees must be brought here by using horses. Because students, in the previous video also, I told you, there were no tractors, JCB, machineries, there were no trucks, okay? So, to drag, to carry such a mightiest tree, strongest tree, it is not possible for the 30 foresters. So, king said, by means of horses, we can use horses. If it is not possible for you, take horses. But what is the reply of foresters? It is not possible, they said. No horse could move such a tree even an inch. The problem of horse is, no horse could move. No horse could move such a tree. An inch. That is the problem of horse. That the tree was mightiest, the tree was largest, strongest. So horses, for horses also it's not possible. No horse could move such a tree an inch. No horse could move such a tree an inch. Then king said, by means of bullocks, second animal they wanted to use, bullock.
by means of bullocks, if horses are not able to move such a tree, use bullocks. By means of bullocks, then he said, the bullocks could not possibly force their way through miles of such a dense forest. Yes, bullocks can move such a large tree, but they could not possibly force their way through miles of such a dense forest. Distance is far. Miles are such a dense forest. Such a dense forest. Bullocks. It is not possible that it is not possible for horses also. It is not possible for bullocks also, because bullocks also could not possibly force their way through miles of such a dense forest. Yes, bullocks also, students, cannot, they can move, yes, they can move, but miles of such a dense forest, it is not possible. Miles of such a dense forest. Bullocks, not possible. Horses, not possible. So, then King said, by means of elephants, the third animal is elephants. By means of elephants, then it is hardly possible, for the ground is so marshy that the elephants would sink to their knees in it. Yes, for elephants it is possible, but ground is so marshy. Marshy. Ground is marshy. Ground marshy is what? In ground, mud is there. Mud. Water and mud. Like in rainy season happen, no? On the ground, mud and water, it's called our feet sink in that mud, in that ground. So that's why, because the ground is so marshy, and that the elephants would sink in their knees in it. Elephants also sink. Elephants knees. So if elephants sink, it is hardly possible to drag such a big tree from the forest. Horses could not, bullocks could not, elephants could not. Then students, what to do? Then students, what to do? Very well, said the king angrily. Very well. What you are saying? Horses are not able to, bullocks are not able to, elephants are not able to. What to do? I wanted to build a big palace, and you are saying such nonsense things. Very well. If you cannot bring me such a tree from the forest, if you are not able to bring such a largest, strongest tree from the forest, then you must find it within one of my village parks. Now, sir, it is not possible to bring such a tree from the forest. Yes. Because forest is very far, road also, ground also, marshy. It is not possible for horses, it is not possible for bullocks, it is not possible for elephants also. So if you cannot bring such a tree from the forest, you must find it
within one of my village parks. Bring it here within a week.
So king says, within a week you should bring. Within a week,
time is given for bringing the such a massive tree. 1 week.
Within a week, you should bring such a massive tree from where? From one of my village parks. So, in forest, not possible. Now go to the village parks. Now go to the village parks. Village parks. One of my village parks. So that is called village park. Find out such a massive tree. Because in village parks, such a massive or strongest trees are there. So the foresters left and went directly to a splendid sal tree which grew not far from the palace. It was worshipped by the people of many villages around because within it dwelt a tree spirit who gave the tree its great strength, size and beauty. The foresters decided with much reluctance that the king's column must be made from this lordly sal tree and from no other. Now students, I am going to introduce sal tree, because name of the nation is the great spirit of sal tree, the great spirit of sal tree. And the background of this story, I told you that a king wanted to build a palace and he wanted such a massive tree, and the foresters were not able to find such a strongest tree in the forest. So now they came to the village's parks. They came to the village parks, students, and now what happened we will see. Now what happened we will see. Yes. The foresters left and went directly to a splendid sal tree. Yes, students, they found a splendid sal tree. Such a massive sal. They went directly to a splendid sal tree, and the sal tree grew not far from the palace. That sal tree was near, very near from that palace, not far from that palace. So it is easy to drag, it is easy to carry also. So that's why that sal tree which grew not far from the palace. And the sal tree was worshipped by the people also. Yes. Many people of the villages worship this tree. Worship the tree. Because they think, the villagers, the people, they think that this tree has tree spirit. Spirit means what? Ghost or supernatural power. Ghost or supernatural power. So that's why, because of that ghost, because of that soul, supernatural power, villagers or people worship that sal tree. So sal tree worshipped by the people of many villages around because
Within it dwelt a tree spirit. Yes.
Within the star tree, tree spirit dwelt. Tree spirit. Ghost of tree. Supernatural power of tree.
Soul of tree. Okay, ghost of tree, supernatural power of tree dwelt. Dwelt means leaves.
Within it lives a tree spirit who gave the tree its great strength, size and beauty. Yes. The star tree has great strength, size also and beauty also. Means what type of tree he wanted, that type of tree was sand. Why? Because great strength, size also was big, beautiful also. And I just want to tell you students that sand tree, which is used to build building accessories, because it is a strongest tree. We can use sal tree to build a building. Its wood is very strong. So that's why foresters decided to cut this tree only. They decided to cut this tree because that tree was very strong. Size was very large and big and massive tree, mightiest tree, and that's why. And also for king also ordered go to village park and cut down and bring such a tree. So foresters decided with much reluctance that the king's column must be made from this lordly sal tree and from no other. Yes, the foresters also decided, students, that a column of palace must be made by only sal tree, because they thought the sal tree is really big, large, beautiful, and it is nearby palace only. It is helpful, it is easy to carry such a tree. So they decided that the column of palace must be made by sal tree. So students, this is the story of the greatest spirit of the sal tree. Sal tree also was there, students, but spirit lives. Spirit also lives. Ghost of sal tree. Supernatural power of sal tree also lives there. They returned to it with garlands, lamps, and music to offer them to the spirit inside and to warn him that he must leave his abode, for within 7 days it would be cut to the ground. They returned to it with garlands, lamps, and music. Yes, students. When they decided to cut sal tree, they went again and they returned back. They returned to the sal tree. Who? Foresters. Foresters returned to the sal tree, and foresters also knew that the ghost of sal tree, spirit of sal tree, lives on it. So that's why they returned with garlands, lamps, and music to offer them to the spirit inside, because inside of sal tree there lives spirit of sal tree. And they warn spirit Foresters warned Spirit that Spirit must leave his place. Where does live Spirit? Inside the salt. So that Spirit must leave his place because within 7 days that salt tree would be cut to the ground. So that's why this is important that they returned to it with garlands, lamps and music to offer them to the Spirit inside and to warn him that he must leave his place, for within 7 days it would be cut to the ground. So before cutting the salt tree, spirit of salt tree should be leave his home, leave his place, any other place. That spirit should take any other place because we are going to cut salt tree, and that's why they warned Spirit. Who warned? Foresters warned Spirit that you should leave this tree. So that's why they offer garlands, lamps and music. Students, the great Spirit of salt tree, what he did? Yes, what he did? Very important thing. Students, next what happened? The tree spirit heard and understood well enough what was about to happen. It remained quite as a resting breeze blew for a few moments, and then all his leaves began to whisper, and his topmost branches bowed. And the foresters went away satisfied that he had answered their plea. But this was what the leaves were whispering to each other. The tree spirit heard. What heard? Because the tree spirit inside, he was inside the salt tree, and that tree spirit heard and he understood that the tree is going to be cut. So he understood, and after some moment all his leaves began to whisper. Whisper means what? Speaking. That is called whisper, speaking with each other in low sound, low voice. And his topmost branches bowed, and the foresters thought that he agreed. Foresters went away satisfied, and they thought that tree spirit agreed, that he had answered their pleas. So that's why they thought that yes, tree spirit agreed. But students, actually the leaves of tree spirit or tree, they were whispering different thing. The tree spirit not agreed, he did not agree, he was disagree. The tree spirit understood, but he was not agree, he was disagree that this salt tree is going to be cut within 7 days. Tree spirit was disagree. So that's why the name of the lesson given here, the great spirit of the salt tree. So students, what happened next with the spirit of salt tree? What happened next with salt tree? And what happened next with foresters, king and what happened about the big palace of king? What did the spirit of Sarthi? Can remaining lesson students, remaining story of the great spirit of the Sarthi, we will continue in the next video. But I suggest you students that this is also very interesting story. Read it at home. Read it carefully at home. Solve, complete your homework regularly and send your homework to the subject teachers. This is Kharadi sir. Thank you. I will be discussing the remaining story of Sarthi in the next video. Thanks a lot.